Good afternoon. Welcome to Mass today. Welcome to Sacred Heart. Thank you for joining us. First and foremost, you'll have noticed if you were here last weekend that the sound system's not popping anymore. So we're very thankful for that. They did come and fix the sound system. It was the amplifier that was going bad. I also had them get a around-the-ear microphone too, which, by the way, can get really loud. Without any interference now. I could bump it up so much louder, and I was telling people if you're out in the playground, you could still hear me out there if I bumped it up loud enough. So I'm super happy, and someone even donated half the cost of the new amplifier, so thank you so much to them. But it's working, so I'm very thankful for that. Also, on Friday, we did have the Blessing of the Animals. This Monday is actually St. Francis of Assisi's feast day, so we had the Blessing of the Animals on Friday. Thank you to all those who brought little goats, goldfish, crab, and the cats and dogs as normal to be blessed. If you would like your pet blessed, feel free to talk to me and we can get that scheduled, or we can do it sometime soon. Wanted to also mention that this Sunday, tomorrow, Preston has their crop walk right in the park right next to St. Joseph's. So again, registration starts at 12:30 and the walk starts at 1 o'clock. So feel free to join St. Joseph's in their crop walk tomorrow afternoon. And then finally wanted to mention that this Tuesday, Mass is at a different time. Usually Mass is at 5:30, but this Tuesday, Mass is at 6:30, so it's an hour later. The Catholic Daughters have their initiation ceremony, so everyone is welcome to come, but our normal Mass is at 6:30 this Tuesday, at 6:30 this Tuesday. And let us stand and let us greet each other. And let us gather together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and my sisters, As we gather together today to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads, and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all wild animals, but none proved to be the suitable partner for man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and then the two of them become one flesh." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, he, for a little while, was made lower than the angels, that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. For it was fitting that he, for whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, should make the leader to their salvation perfect through suffering. He who consecrates and those who are being consecrated all have one origin. Therefore, he is not ashamed to call them brothers. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Pharisees approached Jesus and asked, "It is lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing him. He said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, "Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her." But Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." In the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about this, and he said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her, and if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." And the people were bringing children to him that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." Then he embraced them and blessed them, and placing his hands on them. The gospel of the Lord. Today is about marriage and community. When a couple is married in the church, in front of the whole community, they do not go through marriage alone. The community of believers is with them to support and nourish them through good times and bad. I come from a big family, and there are a lot of my relatives that have been married for over 50 years. I think about all the good and bad times they have encountered together and had to go through. It was always their faith in God that got them through, and the community of people they saw each Sunday at church. When reflecting on the readings today, I kept thinking about what God was saying, two shall become one. 2 + 1 = 3. We begin to see why the love of a husband and wife is a sacrament of God's love. The Father and the Son, while remaining distinct, give themselves utterly to each other. This mutual giving is the Holy Spirit. There it is again, three persons, the Holy Trinity. When two people come together in love and form one flesh, they mimic the love between the Father and the Son. And when their love gives rise to a child, this mimics sacramentally the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. Father, mother, and children, or husband, wife, and community, are evocative of the divine Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. There it is again, three persons, or in some cases, maybe more. God's love for each other began since the beginning of creation, when he created everything. He created man and woman in his own image, different but alike. His love and mercy for us abounds in Scripture. He sent his only begotten Son into the world to save us all, to show us all how to live as a community, and to give us the greatest gift of love for us by dying on the cross for all of us. The Holy Spirit came to be with us, to show us how to keep on loving everyone and caring for everyone as Jesus did. Marriage is always showing through all the joy, pain, sorrow, and peace you will have in your life, always being there for each other. Your love and God's love will always get you through. I asked my older relatives what helped them get through the bad times, and they told me, reading the Bible, praying the rosary, and going to church. Why go to church? Because that community will pray with you, and God will see that the love and help you get through it. You are never alone, no matter who you are. You have three. You have God, you, and me. That is what makes any relationship work. If you take God out of your life, you forget how to love. As the children love Jesus, and as he loved them, it is all about love. You have to work at it. You have to work for it, and you have to let God be in it.
And let us proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate to the Virgin Mary and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting in the Lord in our lives and in our community, we turn to him today with all of our prayers.
For the church, that we might be a sign of communion between God and humanity, and a means of reconciliation amongst all people, we pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders and legislators, that their policies support and strengthen families, we pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all married or engaged couples, that they may recognize Christ in each other, grow into true oneness of life, and bring God's love to others, we pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have experienced or have been impacted by divorce, that God will heal their pain, renew their sense of self, and help them find support and understanding in our community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, especially those with cancer and those recovering from surgery, that God will bring healing and strength to their bodies, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members listed in our Parish Book of Intentions, and especially for Margaret Mary Miller, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they all experience the peace and joy of God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, we know you are always with us and seek to unite yourself with us. Help us always to look towards you for salvation, for true love, and for true joy. Grant our prayers today through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Back to your seats. Thank you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through these sacred mysteries, which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation. Through Christ, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Holy bread, Lord,
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not in our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lord's peace, Father.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. God, you take away. Grant us peace. Grant us
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words, and my soul shall be healed. By the grace of the Savior, eternal life. Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received so as to be transformed into what we consume. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.